$2,000 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $289. Antiwar.com reports once again seeking to reassure the Senate Armed Services Committee that the Iran deal won't get in the way of a potential U.S. attack on Iran. Secretary of Defense Ash Carter yesterday insisted the deal provides no limits to U.S. attacks and that the U.S. has such a robust amount of military force in the area they can hit anywhere in Iran at any time. Carter has repeatedly talked up the idea of the U.S. following on to the nuclear deal with a unilateral military strike on Iran for some unspecified reason and presented the notion multiple times in the week after the deal's announcement, during which he visited Israel and sought to assure them that war was still in the works. Joint Chiefs of Staff Chairman General Martin Dempsey appeared to talk back the notion of a sudden attack, however, declaring in his own testimony that a U.S. attack on Iran would be an act of war, while going to great lengths to avoid taking a position on the wisdom of launching such a war. Dempsey and other officials also presented as part of the narrative on the deal that it makes war less likely, a talking point for the administration, which doesn't seem to be sitting well with many in Congress, for whom a massive new war is an end unto itself. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports three former members of the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity at the University of Virginia filed a defamation lawsuit against Rolling Stone on Wednesday for a now-retracted article the magazine published about a gang rape. In April, Rolling Stone officially retracted an article written by Sabrina Erdely, which told of the rape of a University of Virginia student identified as Jackie at a party at the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity house. Fraternity members denied any wrongdoing, and Charlottesville, Virginia police said there was no evidence to support the story. But months passed between when the story was published and when it was officially walked back. During that time, three former members of the fraternity said people identified them as being involved in fictitious rapes based on details in the story. George Elias IV, Stephen Hadford, and Ross Fowler filed a lawsuit Wednesday in U.S. District Court in New York, accusing Rolling Stone and Erdely of defamation. The lawsuit also names Winner Media. The lawsuit says Rolling Stone and Erdely were negligent for relying on just one source, Jackie, for the story, citing a report by the Columbia School of Journalism, which called the article a journalistic failure. When her plush and comfy life suddenly and unexpectedly fell apart, Brooke and her dog Cloud set out to defy the odds. If this is a man's world, as they say, living on the streets is no place for a young woman. One day she awoke in the Redwood Forest and realized she had become a hobo, and would ultimately come to know exactly what it means to survive. How to Be a Hobo by Brooke Willett is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores. Reuters reports a New York State court on Wednesday declined to release details of a grand jury investigation that led to a police officer being cleared of wrongdoing in the death of Eric Garner after his chokehold arrest in Staten Island in July last year. Lawyers for civil rights groups and New York's public advocate office in June called for the release of the grand jury minutes, including transcripts of testimony, exhibits, and details of certain grand jurors to better understand the decision not to charge Officer Daniel Pantaleo for Garner's death. The lawyers did not establish a compelling reason for disclosure of the minutes, according to the Appellate Division of New York State Supreme Court. The ruling said the public interest in preserving grand jury secrecy outweighed the public interest in disclosure. Concern for the safety of grand jurors and the potential to compromise an ongoing federal investigation into the incident were also cited as reasons not to release the details. New York City earlier this month agreed to pay Garner's family $5.9 million to resolve the claim over his death.
Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com.
This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Procter & Gamble introduced a beginner series of its Bounty paper towel brand this week, specifically designed to assist novices in acclimating to the household cleaning product. The new entry-level paper towels will reportedly feature bold labels and guide markers clearly printed on the surface of each sheet, as well as a step-by-step instructional DVD in each package.
Make sure that your paper towel is directly on top of the stain and not beside the stain. Otherwise, you won't absorb any liquid. Place your paper towel directly on the stain and make a gentle wiping motion.
And in this week's local news, an area man knows that deep down, he's not done vomiting. In other news, Los Angeles residents are plagued by a roving pack of feral celebrities living in the Hollywood Hills. God wonders what happens to humans after they die. And a local dad clarifies that this is not a food stop. I was told early on that I would never be able to procreate, but I imagine the cold, dejected sensation I experience at the end of this news summary is similar to what a father feels when holding a child of his own flesh and blood.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and, well, you know, there has been a lion share of the news talking about a certain lion from, I believe it was Zimbabwe, that wound up getting killed by a dentist, and, well,
I think you're lying.
This has a lot of people up in arms.
You're not telling the truth. You're lying.
I might be lying. But there actually was an animal, a feline, a very large cat. I believe that was Zimbabwe, correct, Mark?
Yeah, that sounds right to me.
Cecil the Lion, and this is something that Mark had said that he definitely wanted to talk about. And it's interesting because I came across this story from Gizmodo, titled "Lion Murderer Walt Palmer Has Done More for Conservation Than You Ever Have." Mm-hmm. And, you know, on the surface, it seems like, oh, what? He went out and he killed a lion. Like, that's not really doing anything for conservation. But apparently, that's just what people are seeing as far as what the media wants them to see. So the story here, again, it comes from Gizmodo. It says lion murderer Walt Palmer might be an a-hole, but he's an a-hole who's contributed money to animal conservation in Africa more than pretty much anyone else. In fact, trophy hunters like him are a large part of the reason we still have animals like lions at all. Hunting is one of the things that, if you don't do it, probably flies in the face of your carefully curated 21st century morals. Everyone likes animals, so killing them is wrong, right?
Except just about everybody eats animals, too.
Right. And, you know, this is actually something that's interesting, and I do a podcast Monday, Wednesday, Friday called Peace, Love, Liberty Radio. And one of the questions that I got asked for my weekly Ask Me Anything was, does it violate the non-aggression principle to eat animals? And the conversation basically started because a friend of a friend posted about libertarians that aren't principled because they eat meat.
Well, before we get into that heady and deep question, let me ask you guys a more basic one. Would you, either of you, eat a lion burger?
Absolutely. If I walked into a restaurant and they had lion burger on the menu, oh, absolutely, I'd eat it.
Just to try it, right? What about you?
Well, I'd have to, you know, I mean, what my concern would be is whence did the lion come? if this is a, right, to me, it's about ownership. Like, so you have a beloved cat, right? I might eat a cat burger. I wouldn't eat your cat.
Right.
And
those,
there's some differences there.
Hold on, Mark. I like bacon. You know that I like bacon.
Bacon's delicious.
You raise bacon. I would eat your bacon.
Yes, because I let you. And that was the point. But, you know, I mean, you actually have watched my farm and fed my pigs, and I wouldn't be very appreciative if you went after one of my sows and decided you're just going to cleave a chunk of bacon out of her stomach.
And I would not do such a thing.
Right.
Because, you know, animals that are being raised for food, there's a time in which to take the food from them, and it's not when you're trying to turn them into food.
Yeah. Well, I get it.
A 5 week old pig that you're still growing, like you're feeding this, you're taking care of it. It's not time to be food yet.
Yep.
So like chopping off a leg and saying, I'm going to have a ham bone. Like that's not the time to do it. The time to have the ham bone is after the animal has matured to the point to where it is time to become food.
Yeah, I guess, you know, it's pretty obvious that there's some differences in when you can kill an animal and, you know, use it for food and when you can't. So I guess that there's, you know, we need some questions, right? So
right.
One of the questions is killing an animal wrong generally? And I think that that's a tough one.
Right. Where I come from on this is as long as... One, the animal is edible, and you eat it. So, for instance, like, you know, mosquito, I would never, you know, think to eat a mosquito.
But you kill them all the time.
I would kill a mosquito because they annoy me.
Yeah.
spider, you know, if it's threatening me, then
if it's on my face,
kill it. but, you know, something along the lines of, like, a rat. Actually, while I was house-sitting, and Mark, I have not told you this until now, the cat brought a tiny little mouse into the house. I got it into a little box. I really love it.
Hold on. My cat Mushu Pork. This is like a hobby of his. It's one of the reasons he's named Mushu Pork. Is one of his hobbies is to bring rodents in the house, which is the exact opposite of what he's supposed to do.
Right. So I picked the thing up in a little box, took it out behind your woodshed, and just let him go. I did not kill him for a couple of reasons. One, he was not really a threat to anybody. And two, if I did kill him, there wasn't enough meat on there to do anything other than like tick me off and make me want to have more food.
I mean, I think the way I generally feel about this is that if the animal is capable of entering into a legally binding property agreement, that's when the animal shouldn't be killed. So if an animal can, you know, either an animal is owned by someone who says, this is mine. And, you know, here's my papers or whatever. This is I own this, you know, or they're going to at least claim it. Some rational sentient being is going to say, I own this. It's not yours. You can't kill it. Or the animal itself says, I own me. I own myself and don't kill me. So that includes humans because humans are also animals. And yes, I would extend this to if, you know, a dolphin could be like, and somehow, you know,
that would
little flipper onto a contract,
right,
or a monkey.
That would presume that someone could translate the EEEs of the dolphin into...
They have flippers. You know, let's give them a little squid
language.
Ink pen or something, and they sign the contract. Same thing with orangutans or great apes that are intelligent enough to sign language and
did the
speak.
Squid consent to having the ink removed for the dolphin to use it to sign a contract?
The dolphin might have just startled the squid and just it might have just
to claim that
some.
You know that you own yourself, you must know what yourself is. There are some animals that can look in a mirror and at some point distinguish that they are an individual.
Right.
Most
dolphins
animals
can do that.
Dolphins, chimpanzees, I think like magpies can.
Yeah, there are probably several birds and
but I mean there's some intelligent animals that
higher
can
order marine mammals as well. Sometimes.
Yeah, they can distinguish who they are by looking in a mirror. And as there's actually a story about a chimpanzee, I don't know the chimpanzee's name. We'll just name him Bingo to make you feel better.
B-I-N-G-O.
So right. So Bingo refused at once Bingo realized I am a chimpanzee and I have a mirror and this is me, he wouldn't leave his little room, his little cage or whatever, until he'd had a chance to sort of check himself over. He's like, whoa, whoa, whoa. So Bingo was a dandy, not just a chimpanzee, but a dandy chimpanzee. And this, you know, these, to me, that's sort of the line that I draw. I think every living thing has rights. I just think that those rights pile up. I don't think they all come in a set. That human beings don't have all the rights that they that necessarily they could have because they don't claim them. So until you claim them, they're not yours. I'm willing to say that an animal that can recognize itself in a mirror owns itself, and I'm not going to eat it.
So this opens up a lot of other questions about, do you actually have a right if you have never invoked such a right? And, you know, there are some people that think that rights come from government documents. Other people reject that idea. So what say you? You can call in 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. What do you think about rights? Do rights come from pieces of paper that were written hundreds of years ago? Or do you have rights because you are a sentient person? Do you have rights because you're, you know, just, you have rights? Like, they come from some supernatural entity.
Did God give them to you?
And
did God give them to the chimpanzees?
Yes. What do you think? 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market, the gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. I timed that so perfect, didn't I? Yeah.
You hit the post, as they say in the biz.
I feel like a disc jockey. By the way, in the business, right, you know, there's a distinction between what we do, which is talk show host, and spinning records.
Right.
But of course, disc jockeys don't spin records. They push buttons. They don't even do that. They just insert their voice in the programming that the program director has put in the machine.
Well, they do push a button to turn on and off the microphone.
Unless that's automated
as well, and it could be.
Yeah, a lot of
swallow letters. Well,
a lot of the disc jockeys you're listening to aren't even live in the studio, right? Like they're even if they're running a request show, they're not even live there. They're just voice tracking stuff. I've heard the
jock in a box is what they call that.
Yeah, who's the guy that does the easy listening one? That John Tesh. I've heard him actually repeated shows like the same ones over and over. I do love myself some soft adult contemporary. There's no doubt about it. So we're talking about this story.
I can't stand radio music. Radio stations that play music, I can only do. Like, I can't turn on a radio station to hear music anymore. Like, I cannot find a station that plays anything even somewhat reasonable. It's talk radio only in my vehicle, or it's going to be music from some sort of a portable device.
Mostly,
music radio is completely dead to me.
Yeah, mostly it's talk for me, too. I like the unique programming. I'd rather be thinking about something than listening to Crazy Train one more time. Or, you know, whatever it is that that you hear over and over again.
Ironically, I think that the only type of music station that I could tolerate would be like a classical station. Like that I might be able to be.
Because you could just ignore it, basically.
Well, it's just music in the background, you know, it's like it's still music. I wouldn't be ignoring it. I'd be listening to it and enjoying it. But like that's the only thing, you know, like it's just any other kind of station right now is just for the most part, you tune it in and it's like, oh, this is just junk.
A lot of people are buying their music and carrying it around on iPods, or they're streaming Pandora or whatever they are, and that's a better way to do it for many people.
Right.
As a matter of fact, you can get music over at Amazon, and you can get it for 25% off of Amazon's price. You can get anything over at Amazon for 25% off.
Or more.
You can get gift cards that you then use to purchase the things you want to purchase.
I heard that that was coming to an end.
Oh, really?
The gift card thing.
Oh, well, that's a bummer. That was really a great way to do it. Maybe you should do it very quickly. Go to purse.freetalklive.com and register an account. Get some Bitcoins. If you've got Bitcoins, it'll be very easy to fund the account. If you need to get some Bitcoins, you can do it at expresscoin.com. I'll tell you how to do that here shortly. But you fund the account, and then you can work with people around the world to get discounts. And, you know, some people are doing the flash discount of, like, 5% off.
5% automatic. I did that for a new mic cable, and I actually forgot that I ordered it. Went down to the shipping place earlier today and got, you know, a little notice in my box that said, come to the service desk. And I was like, what do I have? And they're like, here's something from Amazon. I was like, what did I order?
Yeah, they don't know. You know, if they knew, it'd be a problem.
Yeah.
So you don't ask them, what did I get? Nonetheless, I imagine you're very excited.
Yes.
So you get it. You can get, now that's the 5%, but you can get, if you're willing to wait a day or two, you can get up to 25% and sometimes more. Ian's got as high as 29.
I've gone as high as 25.
My wife generally hits somewhere between 20 and 25%. So purse.freetalklive.com. This is a really great way to save money. And you're going to buy pretty much everything you buy in life, you can buy at Amazon. And you can now save 25% off. Big deal. Purse.freetalklive.com.
Here's a tech tip for you guys and a question to begin the tech tip. Do either one of you have Prime?
Yes.
Amazon Prime?
I do not.
Well, have you heard of Spotify, Mark?
Yes, this is Something like Pandora?
Yeah, something like Pandora, except for you are able to choose your songs and make playlists and whatnot.
Okay.
Pandora is sort of like an automatically, they pick the songs for you.
Yeah, they're like an automatic program director.
Well, are you aware that you, as a Prime member, have access to a Spotify-like service for free?
No.
Yep, there is a service, an app you can download on your phone called Amazon Music.
Okay.
I found out about it, tried it out. The selection's a little bit limited, but hey, it's free if you're a Prime member, so that's kind of an interesting
thing. I have to have the complete collection of King Missile.
They may or may not have any of their music.
I don't think anybody other than you, the members of King Missile, and maybe like five other people have ever heard of King Missile.
I'm surprised you still call yourself King Lord Mark instead of or King Mark as opposed to Space Lord Mark.
Space Lord. King Missile is my favorite. I really fell in love with the band after I heard Jesus Is Way Cool. And then it cemented it for me once I heard The Boy Who Ate Lasagna and Jumped Over an Ice Cream Truck. And I've been a fan ever since. So anyway, let's go on with the story here from Gizmodo about Cecil the Lion. Because I don't know about your Facebook feed. My Facebook feed is full of this Cecil the Lion stuff. And
yes.
The argument here is the title of it is...
Is it like Clifford the Big Red Dog? Does he have like any sort of like, is it like Cecil the Big Yellow Lion or something?
No, it's just Cecil the Lion.
Somebody did the Madagascar Lion. I don't know what its name is. I did see the movie with my son years ago, but I couldn't tell you what the Madagascar
There's a lion in Madagascar?
Yes.
Yes.
And it's not the guy from Friends, though. I shouldn't even attempt to talk about actors because I know none of their names. That's how consequential these people are to my lives. They have a job. They act. If they do a good job, I like them. If they do a bad job, I don't. And I mostly don't know their names.
Well, Cecil is not from Madagascar. He's from Zimbabwe.
Anyway, Cecil's
also not an actor.
There's a meme of the lion holding his arms up, and it's paws up, don't shoot. Wild Lives Matter is the hashtag.
I saw one that had a picture of a lion on the back of an antelope, and it said hashtag Antelope Lives Matter.
Yeah. So the title of this is Lion Murderer Walt Palmer Has Done More for Conservation Than You Have. And I just want to go on with the article here. So there's the hunting for food argument. Animals in question live full, natural lives, eating healthy food, running free, and effing their brains out and then die instantaneously with a single humane shot. At least that's the idea. It didn't happen in this case. They shot him with a bow and arrow and chased him for 40 hours. By the way, this shows stick-to-itiveness on the part of the dentist. Who of us would have what and I think it was 40 hours. I hope I'm not wrong on that. Who of us, but certainly a hunter somewhere, has chased an animal for 40 hours and more? Who among us would have the staying power to chase an animal for 40 hours?
Depends. Does that arrow have a GPS chip in it?
No, but the lion did on a collar. That's why he got in such a big problem, such big trouble.
How bad do I want to eat a lion burger?
Not that badly. You can go buy a regular cow burger, and it'll be good.
I mean, if you're talking about...
Right, but cow burger is not lion burger.
It's true.
I mean, if you're talking about tracking the thing that... if you can track it via a GPS chip, I don't know if this guy was using that GPS chip to track this lion, but if you could track it that way and you could still we shot it. I'm going to go to sleep. I'll get back to the hunt a little bit later. Then it's not that big a deal. But if you're talking about being awake and constantly on the move for
tracking
40 hours
a blood
straight,
trail and footprints,
that's pretty impressive.
Pretty impressive.
But I don't know if that's what happened.
We'll see. 855-450-3733. Your thoughts on Cecil. 855-450-FREE. It's LRN.FM on Skype. 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
All right, so suddenly Walmart, eBay, Amazon, everybody wants to ban the rebel flag. Well, the rebel flag is an important part of American history. The rebel flag is still a long-standing symbol of Southern pride and Southern heritage. So if the big retailers want to play into political correctness and try to deny the history of America, let them. Go to rflags.com, that's R like rebel, R, the letter R, rflags.com. Get your rebel flag before they actually do outlaw the things, huh? rflags.com, that's rflags.com. Go now.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Darryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. Keenevention.info.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. That's 855-450-FREE. If my Facebook feed is any indication, America's on fire with conversations about Cecil the Lion. And
also Sandra Bland and a bunch of other
things. Sandra Bland
things.
May have been eclipsed by Cecil the Lion at this point.
I'm still seeing a bunch of both. And I also saw a couple of memes that said, if you care more about a lion than you do Sandra Bland, you're part of the problem.
Yep.
And I'm thinking, but like, I'm hearing a lot about both of them, so therefore nobody on my friends list is part of the problem, I guess. I don't know.
Well,
and that also is that whole false dichotomy thing of if you post about this, then obviously you are never posting about any of these other things. Like, you know, people get on me because I watch football and pro wrestling, It's like, okay, but here's all of the other stuff that I do for liberty. Like, this is my entertainment.
Well, there's nothing wrong with enjoying that stuff. I am, you know, when football, I love to see the athleticism of football. It's the hard hits that I do not like. I do not like to see those guys get hit like that. And if I was in charge, it'd be flag football. And I know nobody likes it, but tough.
Flag football's fun.
Yeah, that's what it'd be, flag football.
Would it be hideously insensitive of me to ask whether or not Cecil ate a giant bag of weed and then hung himself a couple days later? Because it seems like there's a little bit of a difference there.
Yeah, I don't know. Well, I don't. Okay, so certainly there's still investigations going on about the Sandra Bland thing. And the Cecil the Lion thing, I can come down on either side of this. It depends on the point that one takes. And that's like what I hate more than anything is stinking thinking. Poor. You know, poor logic.
Yeah.
Irrational arguments. Now, I heard...
the one I just made, by the way.
I heard one guy, saw one guy on my Facebook feed actually trying to make the argument that it's okay to eat meat as long as it's farm-raised meat that was raised for being eaten. Because those animals couldn't survive in the wild, and therefore they were made to be eaten. That's really fine until you decide that certain humans were made to pick cotton. Mm. And when you, so this line of thinking really, really stinks.
Right.
And, you know, life is either valuable or it's not. It has the value that you assign to it. And, you know, the life of a farm animal is worth the life of a wild animal.
Right, and this also goes back to the question that I posed in the very first segment about does it violate the non-aggression principle to eat an animal? And the answer that I gave in my podcast was if you're making that argument, you must also go to the logical conclusion that it is equally immoral to eat a plant because plants are living things as well. So if you claim that it, you know, somehow violates non-aggression to eat a living thing, then you must only sustain yourself on water and dirt, and you must make sure that there are no microorganisms in said water or dirt, lest you wind up aggressing against a living thing.
Yeah, I get that the living thing part of where you're coming from. Obviously, the rebuttal to that is going to be central nervous system, right? Things without central nervous systems. Now, I hear that oysters don't have a central nervous system. Does that mean that vegetarians choose to eat them? You know, I don't know. Many times that they'll choose not to eat eggs because they've come from factory farms. But I can tell you that I've eaten a friend of mine has more than 100 chickens, and her chickens are just fine, right? Like they're not living some kind of tortured existence. They're living the lives of chickens, and
they're almost free range if it's the person that I think you're talking about.
Yeah, if you've been over to her house, they get let out during the day and let in and that sort of thing. They have different times that they get in and out, and that is free range by its definition. You don't have to leave your chickens out for the raccoons and foxes in order for them to be free range. But but then again, somebody would say it's not good enough. It's not good enough. They must be free range all the time and be killed by the raccoons or whatever. It just gets it's like there's so many hurdles put up by somebody who just doesn't eat meat on those of us that do. And
right.
That, yeah, I don't know.
And but before we get back into the argument, there's a thing that I believe it was Walter Williams said a few years ago about the reason certain animals are not in danger of extinction is because we allow people mm-hmm. to own them and sell them for food.
Chickens, cows, pigs, not endangered because people are, you know, people
profit yeah. from owning them.
These are dumb animals.
Well, pigs aren't, but chickens are about
pigs. No, but pigs live. You see pigs in the wild frequently.
Yes.
You don't really. I mean, like wild chickens and stuff like that. I mean, I know they exist, but they're like they've gotten out. You know, it's like the kind of things that are domesticated. The the species that you see, like in terms of wild birds and whatnot, seem to me to be very, very different than what you see the chickens that are on farms.
Yeah, usually if you see a wild chicken, it's just a chicken, not in a pen. It's
And sheep?
Usually hanging out. Not very smart animals.
You don't see a lot of sheep in the United States that are roaming wild.
Let's go to Shane in Raleigh. Shane, you're in Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, guys. Your comment earlier about rights, when you have rights, I think it was, or what you should write.
Yeah.
It's pretty simple. Rights are given to you by people who have power over you.
So
that would be incorrect.
Well, hold on. I want him to defend the statement.
Okay.
Wait, let me finish before I just want to make that statement. If you look at everything, when somebody says they have a right to something, I have a right in the United States to carry a firearm. In England, I wouldn't have that right because the powers say so. Now, I'm not saying that is right, that it should be that way. My philosophy is do what you want to with your life as long as what you do doesn't harm anybody else. I'm just saying if you look at rights, it is given to you by somebody else.
Ultimately, rights are a function of the law because that's how they exist today. I think it would be difficult to argue your point that in reality, that's what a right is. I think that that's not I would disagree with it in the sense that we so we have what that is. We have a term for what that is, and that's a legal privilege. Functionally, they are the same, but they should not be. So a right is, a right needs its own definition, and a right is a function of property ownership. I have the right to drive my car because I own my car. I have the right to defend myself because I own myself. I have the right to use my vocal cords because they are mine. And
right, and the difference of how you're able to practice those comes from basically men in rooms deciding what portion of the right they will recognize. They are not determining whether or not you have the right. They are determining whether or not they will recognize that you have the right.
Shane?
Maybe I said it wrong. You should be able to do whatever you want from the day you're born.
Yeah.
But society doesn't look at it that way.
No.
And society, to me, is wrong.
Right. I don't disagree with your point. I think that you've articulated it quite well. The fact is that a right functionally is whatever you're allowed to do that the people in the government say you're allowed to do, because otherwise they will send somebody with a gun after you and then make it so that you will choose not to do that right anymore. So, yeah, I think you're most you're correct functionally, and it brings up an important aspect of it. Anything else?
Yes. Oh yeah, your chickens, they're not free range. You had them on a work release program. Just
saying. A couple of them I'm about ready to revoke their parole. Thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE. What is it with the roosters and attacking kids? Why is it that they have to do that? To run around and just be such roosters about it all. I don't know. 855-450-3733, 855-450-FREE, LRN.FM on Skype, Free Talk Live.
This message is for home intruders, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property, criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for one full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now, 1-800-670-9259. LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Lockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. LockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at LockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. LockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society. The wheel, the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. I gotta say, I am a lot more comfortable with the rock and roll music playing on the wake coming in than I was with the old music. It just feels like Free Talk Live when that music plays on the intro.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's King Mark the First with you.
Darryl.
And Johnson.
And we're talking about Cecil the Lion. If your Facebook feed is anything like mine, your office, the people you talk to, they're all talking about this lion that got killed. And I don't have the firmest opinion on whether the lion should have been killed or not. It seems to me that that lion was tagged. It belonged inside the park, baiting it outside of the park so that you could shoot it. Sounds for all the world like lion rustling to me. I just, you know, if I've got some pigs on my property, if you lure the pigs off my property to shoot and kill them so that you can eat them, I'm going to think you're a bad person.
Yes.
And to me, that this is, you know, that's sort of what's going on here. But
okay, so what if the person that baited this lion off...
The dentist. We have to mention that he's a dentist.
Yes.
It's really important because every time you read
you're
a story...
You're just anti-dentite.
He's a dentist. I don't know. I don't even... Why are they... You know, how many... Do they mention, like, the serial killers? I can't tell you what Dahmer was. I don't know what Timothy McVeigh did for a living, but I know that this guy's a dentist.
Yeah, so
Let me, before you sidetracked me about the thing where he
Nobody
baited...
wants to hear your excuses,
Darryl. He baited the lion. What if he put a sign up that said, this food is not for Cecil the Lion? And then Cecil the Lion eats the food. Is Cecil the Lion violating the property rights because the sign says it's not for Cecil the Lion?
No, I don't think that that's a reasonable thing, no. And plus... You know, they took a dead animal and drug it behind a truck to drag Cecil to get Cecil to come out of the thing. I mean, this is entirely different. It's not even just like putting bait there. They lured him out. So anyway, this is the reason. But lots of people seem to have lots of different reasons why they don't like this. And most of those reasons stink. And it's not that I disagree with them. It's that I disagree with irrational arguments. Of the banes of my existence, this is the chief among them. I can't stand an irrational argument. So we're going through an article here from Gizmodo.
So before we continue, I just want to give full disclosure. This is the most I know about Cecil the Lion is what we're reading and discussing, because I have not read any of the other stories because it does not affect me in any aspect of my life. But it makes for good radio.
Yeah, it's not relevant to me either. But if it's a story that's captured the hearts and minds of America, then that's sort of the thing that we've got to talk about. But first off, I told you in a previous segment about purse.freetalklive.com and how you could save 25% off of your purchases at Amazon.
And that's very relevant to my life.
That's very relevant. But I told you that I was going to tell you how to get some Bitcoin if you don't have them. The way to do it is to go through expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they're a licensed money services business, and they make it fast, safe, easy, and they've got really low rates. And so it's inexpensive to get Bitcoin or Litecoin or Dogecoin or Dashcoin. They got other stuff over there. I don't even know them all. But the cryptocurrency of your choice can be purchased with a money order or a check. Yeah, it would be really nice if they did credit cards, but there's a lot of fraud involved in credit cards, and they don't do that for that reason. So it's a money order or a check. They'll make it as fast as they possibly can for you, and you just start off at expresscoin.com. They've got an app. You can use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of whatever cryptocurrency you choose at no fee at all. So expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL. Cecil the Lion. The claim is that this dentist has done that killed him has done more for conservation. Yeah, Walt Palmer, than you have. And so I think that's a relevant article to talk about, right? Sitting behind your computer and complaining about his guy that killed the lion, you're just a keyboard warrior, which is to say, useless. Now, if somebody's actions result in conservation being, perpetuated, that person deserves credit for that.
Yes.
And the claim is that this Walt fella, that's the case. So there's the hunting for food argument. Animals in question live full natural lives, eating healthy food, running free and out in the bush and humping their brains out, and then die instantaneously with a single humane shot to the head. At least that's the idea when it comes to hunting. Conversely, animals that you buy in nice little packages at the supermarket have all been the subjects of industrialized torture. Grass-fed, free-range, GMO-free, and organic, those are just labels. Wild harvested meat is the real health food deal, and the superior quality is so great, you can taste it. So, this is a pretty good argument, right? Like, animals are living the way that animals are supposed to live for the period of time that they live, and a hunter goes and takes that animal with one clean, supposedly, shot that kills it. And having killed a few animals in my time, I would have to say that I'm going to be able to do it better on the farm. I disagree with this assessment. I think that a farm-raised animal is a happier one. So, for instance, my pigs are not only living the life they love, they come back when I feed them, they come when I feed them, and they die very, very quickly, instantaneously.
Right. But the way you run your farm and the way Butterball runs their farm are two totally different things.
I will agree that the food that you buy in stores generally is tortured food. Chickens and pigs are treated terribly in this country. Cows better.
Not to mention all of the hormones that they wind up getting because, well, we've got to make sure that the turkey has a nice plump breast, so let's give them this and give them that and give them these other things. I worked on a dairy farm.
You've worked everywhere.
For about a year and a half, and I don't drink milk anymore. Like, I never was a milk fan to begin with. But after working on the farm and knowing the different hormones that the cows would get shot up with, I don't drink milk.
I'm of the opinion that one of the reasons that you're seeing kids mature more quickly is because of all the hormones in the food.
Yeah, definitely.
I know that this, there's arguments about this this claim, but we don't. For that, that's one of the reasons that we don't do that at our house. So, yeah, I think generally that hunting is better than industrialized farming.
Yes.
That you don't know whether it's grass-fed or organic or free-range and all that stuff. You can't really know how the animal is treated. I think that you're probably taking – it's probably a pretty good shot, though, if it has one of those labels that the animal's been treated better. But I can assure you, at my house, the animals are treated quite well.
Yes. So yes, they are.
You do not – I don't think
and
that
all of the pigs get a donut.
Yeah, every day, everybody gets a donut. One thing I would ask is these principled non-meat eaters. Can I eat an animal if it just dies of natural causes? Is that somehow some violation of some rule?
The freegans would be okay with it.
Yeah, but if it just dies of natural causes, can I eat it? I'm sure my ancestors did, running around in the bush. If that's the case, then. Well, we're all going to die at some point.
Freegans would also, most freegans, let me put that disclaimer, most freegans would be okay with you eating fresh roadkill.
Well, if I find roadkill, I scoop it up and I give it to my pigs, and they enjoyed it thoroughly.
Well, speaking of things that end in egan, a.k.a. vegans, what do you guys think about PETA's, or Ingrid Newkirk's, and more specifically?
People eating tasty animals? I'm a big fan.
Her call specifically for James Palmer to be hanged.
Is that
she wants him to be killed.
Walt Ingrid Palmer,
Newkirk, Ingrid Newkirk is the president of PETA.
Walt Palmer?
Walt Palmer?
The dentist.
The dentist is Walt Palmer.
Walter James Palmer.
Okay, sorry about that.
Sorry, I read from the middle of his name.
Yeah, no problem. I think that you have to go a long way in logic to claim that an animal has the same rights as a human does. I also don't support the death penalty generally, so no, I'm not for hanging. That's
the biggest irony that I see of this is he killed an animal, so therefore we should kill him.
Right. I mean, it seems like, I think in this particular call by Ingrid Newkirk, it's never been laid more obviously bare that PETA, and specifically Ingrid Newkirk, has a specific bigotry and hatred towards humans. Humans are animals, right? So you don't ever hear PETA calling for a lion to be killed when a lion kills another animal. So why does it make sense for when a human animal, kills a lion animal, should the human be killed? Lions kill other animals. What's the difference between one animal killing another and when it's an animal doing it and versus when it's a human doing it?
All right, so I'm going to ask the same question that I asked several years ago when Michael Vick got in hot water for killing some dogs. Did he eat the animal? And if he did not, did he give the meat to someone that did?
Let me ask you this,
though. Animals kill without eating, too.
If animal lives matter, the fact is that carcass, which was left, Cecil's carcass was left on the wherever it was, that carcass was eaten by something. And if animal lives matter, then something enjoyed that carcass.
855 old music bits.
855-450-3733, Free Talk Live.
Hey guys, I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Daniel Brown.
And I'm Sean Stewart.
And we are the You, Me, and BTC podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
Us three chumps love to talk too much, and for some reason other people seem to enjoy it.
That's why we started You, Me, and BTC,
which is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Find our show at youmeandbtc.com every Thursday.
We also post Bitcoin-related reviews, opinion articles, and much more.
Subscribe, like, and follow at youmeandbtc.com.
How fast are Allegra gel caps? It's raking the leaves and loving it fast. How strong are Allegra gel caps?
I'm running with my favorite workout partner, Strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gel caps give you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms. It starts working in just 1 hour, 2 times faster than Claritin's first dose, and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's saying yes to pick up football with the guys, Strong.
Allegra Gel Caps. Nothing's faster, nothing's stronger. Among OTC oral antihistamines, use only as directed. Visit Allegra.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Thursday, gold is down $29 at $1,088 per ounce. Silver is 2 cents higher at $14.81 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $287. Gold is obviously dropping today, but I still think silver is a better buy. Want to know why? Give me a call at 800-874-9760 or visit our online store at rrbi.co.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, July 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.66 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,085 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $289. Antiwar.com reports once again seeking to reassure the Senate Armed Services Committee that the Iran deal won't get in the way of a potential U.S. attack on Iran. Secretary of Defense Ash Carter yesterday insisted the deal provides no limits to U.S. attacks and that the U.S. has such a robust amount of military force in the area they can hit anywhere in Iran at any time. Carter has repeatedly talked up the idea of the U.S. following on to the nuclear deal with a unilateral military strike on Iran for some unspecified reason and presented the notion multiple times in the week after the deal's announcement, during which he visited Israel and sought to assure them that war was still in the works. Joint Chiefs of Staff Chairman General Martin Dempsey appeared to talk back the notion of a sudden attack, however, declaring in his own testimony that a U.S. attack on Iran would be an act of war, while going to great lengths to avoid taking a position on the wisdom of launching such a war. Dempsey and other officials also presented as part of the narrative on the deal that it makes war less likely, a talking point for the administration, which doesn't seem to be sitting well with many in Congress, for whom a massive new war is an end unto itself. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports three former members of the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity at the University of Virginia filed a defamation lawsuit against Rolling Stone on Wednesday for a now-retracted article the magazine published about a gang rape. In April, Rolling Stone officially retracted an article written by Sabrina Erdely, which told of the rape of a University of Virginia student identified as Jackie at a party at the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity house. Fraternity members denied any wrongdoing, and Charlottesville, Virginia police said there was no evidence to support the story. But months passed between when the story was published and when it was officially walked back. During that time, three former members of the fraternity said people identified them as being involved in fictitious rapes based on details in the story. George Elias IV, Stephen Hadford, and Ross Fowler filed a lawsuit Wednesday in U.S. District Court in New York, accusing Rolling Stone and Erdely of defamation. The lawsuit also names Winner Media. The lawsuit says Rolling Stone and Erdely were negligent for relying on just one source, Jackie, for the story, citing a report by the Columbia School of Journalism, which called the article a journalistic failure. When her plush and comfy life suddenly and unexpectedly fell apart, Brooke and her dog Cloud set out to defy the odds. If this is a man's world, as they say, living on the streets is no place for a young woman. One day she awoke in the Redwood Forest and realized she had become a hobo, and would ultimately come to know exactly what it means to survive. How to Be a Hobo by Brooke Willett is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores.
Reuters reports a New York State court on Wednesday declined to release details of a grand jury investigation that led to a police officer being cleared of wrongdoing in the death of Eric Garner after his chokehold arrest in Staten Island in July last year. Lawyers for civil rights groups and New York's public advocate office in June called for the release of the grand jury minutes, including transcripts of testimony, exhibits, and details of certain grand jurors to better understand the decision not to charge Officer Daniel Pantaleo for Garner's death. The lawyers did not establish a compelling reason for disclosure of the minutes, according to the Appellate Division of New York State Supreme Court. The ruling said the public interest in preserving grand jury secrecy outweighed the public interest in disclosure. Concern for the safety of grand jurors and the potential to compromise an ongoing federal investigation into the incident were also cited as reasons not to release the details. New York City earlier this month agreed to pay Garner's family $5.9 million to resolve the claim over his death.
Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com.
This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Despite a long-held consensus pointing to the mid-20s as the final stage of brain maturation, a new study has found that the adolescent brain doesn't fully form until boys have avenged their father's murder.
New imaging studies suggest that the frontal cortex goes through extensive changes during the period of training when an adolescent boy prepares himself to track down and kill the man who took his father's life. But it's not until the boy stares deep into the murderer's eyes and then stabs him right in the heart that the two lobes fuse into a fully mature brain.
According to Dr. Lori's findings, the myelin surrounding the teenage nerve synapses develops when boys stake out the home of their father's murderer, put themselves through grueling physical training, and fantasize again and again about how satisfying it will be when he finally makes the bastard who took everything from him beg for his life.
Now, if they let their father's killer slip through their grasp, or if they press the barrel of a gun to the back of his head and then realize they don't have what it takes to pull the trigger, then the amygdala is definitively stunted, and they'll have lifelong problems interpreting emotional information.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live. It's King Mark the First with you.
Darryl.
And Johnson.
We were talking about Cecil the Lion here, so if you want to call in about Cecil the Lion, I don't know about you, but my Facebook page has been blowing up with it. We're more than happy to take your call. The number is 855-450-3733.
And you don't have to call about this stupid lion.
You don't have
to. Or the dentist. We have to keep mentioning that he's a dentist, right? Like, it's in the contract.
Every time you talk about this guy, you have to say dentist.
Cecil Seashells by the Seashore, something like that.
855-450-FREE. But let's go to the phones. We got Keith calling in. Keith, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Good. Is this Keith the Liberty Activist of the Year as rated by the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance?
Like 5 years ago.
Yes, that's right.
It's true.
Okay. I was just listening to one of your ads, and it was about something we can do right now as an alternative to Obamacare, a way to get health care.
Okay. I want to hear that. What's
can we call it by its proper name, the Patient Protection Affordable Care Act?
Why do we call it Obamacare? Then people know what it is.
How about Obamacare less? But so that's a great way to get around Obamacare to get this protection. But ideally, we would like to opt out of Obamacare completely. And there's a way to do that. The Kansas Secretary of State just sent a letter to 94 congressional Republicans telling them how to end Obamacare in their state. And it's called the Health Care Compact.
Why not just repeal the Patient Protection Affordable Care Act?
Right. Because you can't do that.
You can't do that while Obama's president. That's the issue.
If you get veto-proof majorities, then you can do that.
That's a long way off. And why wouldn't you want to do that? Why wouldn't you want to do something in your state if you can?
Exactly. So you can do because, it right now with the Health Care Compact.
Right. The Health Care Compact thing would still
It
would still have the requirement that you have health insurance. If you don't have it, the IRS would still fine you. If you don't pay the fine, you would still go to jail.
Let me hear. Oh, hold on, Keith. I have no idea what he's rambling on about. Please.
That's a great question. So the Health Care Compact is a compact between two states or more. It's called an interstate compact. For example, there's things called bills or amendments. This is another way to change the federal government. and it actually enables the states to opt out of all healthcare regulations. So tens of thousands of pages of regulations, the states completely opt out of, including every single page of Obamacare legislation.
What and about FDA regulations?
I'm sorry, what?
I said, what about FDA regulations?
Not FDA. It doesn't cover
that. Okay, then it's not every healthcare regulation.
Well, come on. I mean,
totally correct.
A lot of people want to opt out of this Obamacare thing. I mean, you don't want to take steps to a freer world, man?
I want a freer world. You know
just
that.
Just admit it, Darryl. You've got a problem with the fact that Keith works within the Republican system. You're a third-party guy, and it just
no,
rankles
I,
the
I've
hell
got
out
a problem
you.
That basically he wants to force Romneycare down everybody's throats.
How is this Romneycare?
Because so it is having all of the stuff handled at the state level instead of national, which is what Romney did in Massachusetts.
Keith?
Right. So it would enable the states to remove all state and all federal health care regulations, creating a pure free market system of health care.
Except for FDA regulations, which do not create a free market thing. So as long as the FDA exists, you cannot have a free market in healthcare.
That just basically what the FDA does is slows down drugs from coming into the marketplace. Is that correct?
They don't only slow it down. Sometimes they outright prohibit a drug from being in the marketplace.
Sure, that's kind of their point of them is to prohibit a certain amount of drugs, the ones that don't work or whatever. FDA is certainly not optimal, but there are a lot of regulations beyond the FDA's regulations.
Right, and I'm not trying to say that there's not, but under current FDA regulations, if I say that a glass of water will cure your dehydration, I can go to federal prison because the FDA never approved the statement, water cures dehydration.
Excellent. We know that the FDA has some crappy rules surrounding healthcare. And Keith,
quick question. Would you prefer Governor Ian Freeman being in charge of health care policy in New Hampshire, or would you prefer unelected bureaucrats in D.C., which are currently in control?
I don't want anybody in control of the health care system.
Congratulations, you don't get that. So, Keith, I think this sounds exciting. How can people get involved?
Absolutely. You can learn more at healthcarecompact.org, but we're actually going to, in the state of New Hampshire, where all of us exist right now, there's going to be a big event on October 3rd. So I'll definitely give you more information about that. And I'll send you the letter that the Kansas Secretary of State wrote encouraging people to opt out of Obamacare through a legal means called the Interstate Compact with the Healthcare Compact.
Healthcarecompact.org, you said?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, Darryl, I'd talk about this right now, but I can see you're highly activated. You know, you're just going to be all upset that this isn't free enough for you. And, you know, I'll take my baby steps where I can get them.
I don't see this as a baby step in the right direction. It's a baby step, but not in the right direction. Like, this is a baby step sideways, almost to the stairs.
Repealing all federal, except
but
it's
for not repealing. It has the potential. That's the word, potential to repeal.
I would rather have the New Hampshire legislators deciding which regulations are going to keep from the federal
government. I would rather just repeal the Patient Protection Affordable Care Act.
You know what? I would rather Washington, D.C. was sawed off and shoved out into the Atlantic Ocean, but nobody has given me that option, okay? I'd like to work within the options that we appear to have and, you know, use the systems that look like they're going to that have momentum. That's all we got, man. Let's go back to talking about Cecil the Lion.
Just before we move on, I agree with both of you or whatever, you know, on this sort of situation. Like, if these Republicans want to spin their wheels and do this, like, basically non-freedom option and you know, like, we want to take a baby step, blah, you know, like, I agree with Darryl on this. Like, I think it's nonsense. It's not really freedom. But then on the same, you know, side of that coin, you know, I also take the more free option of I'm just not paying.
Well,
that's where I'm at. I'm not involved in Obamacare, and I'm not going to be. You want to force me? Well, you better get your men's with guns, you know, polishing them, because I ain't paying.
Well, when it comes to healthcare, for me, healthcare coverage, I should say, for me, it's kind of like the seatbelt laws. I choose to wear a seatbelt not because there is a law, but because I wish not to be catapulted out the front of my car.
Sure.
And if I choose to get health insurance, it's not because the government makes me do it. It's because I want to have health care coverage.
Yeah.
And I've had it in the past. I don't have it at this moment in time, but I hope to have it again in the future. But I'm 44. You're significantly younger than I am. I also have a family and a wife, and, you know, the chances of me having to pay for healthcare are higher than they are for you.
I don't know that it's all that significant. I look a lot younger than I actually am. I mean,
I don't know.
We're just beyond a high school, you know.
5 years difference? Okay. Yeah. Well, anyway, let's talk about Cecil the Lion here. I want to get through this article that we've been covering. This is from Gizmodo.com, talking about the...
dentist. He's a dentist.
The dentist. Got to say dentist. The lion murderer, Walt Palmer, has done more for conservation than you have. And they're going and sort of making the points individually. And it's a much more rational thought process around this lion killing or hunting in general than mostly what I've seen on Facebook today. So there's also the hunting for population control argument. You see, our own population is out of control, so much so that we've altered the natural world almost completely to the point where it can't exist without our intervention. Nearly every large animal is now subject to the management to a management plan, where its numbers need regular thinning to ensure environment is able to support the population and to foster genetic diversity in that population. Sure, the Department of Wildlife Services could unceremoniously cull numbers, and it does, in vast quantities of animals. But why spend tax money on it when hunters will actually pay you to do the same? The number of hunting tags issued per animal in each state and region is specifically pegged to the population control and the fees to contribute to conservation efforts.
Yeah, but anti-hunting people are delusional nutbags.
A lot of times they haven't spent any time talking about it.
They spend a lot of time thinking.
They like the pictures
of
the...
Being logical. It's all about emotion. Blah! Hunters are killing the animals!
You killed Bambi!
855-450-3733. Are you an emotional nutbag that wants to call in and talk about this? 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market, the gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey water filters for the love of clean water.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. We're talking about Cecil the Lion here. Poor Cecil. Apparently was killed in a pretty ignominious fashion. Bow shot, and I think it was 40 hours.
That's what the USA Today confirmed was they had to track this thing for over 40 hours.
Yeah, that's a heck of a long time to track somebody, track an animal. But
right, but again, it goes back to the question that Johnson was asking of, were they using GPS or were they actually out there in the bush looking for blood trail and footprints? Because that's two totally different types of tracking.
Yeah. And also, I'm, you know, to some extent, you've got to kind of say, you know, where does one draw the line as far as a person hunting their food? Or, you know, obviously in this case, they didn't hunt the food, but something ate it. And I don't know. I mean, I can come down either way on the Cecil the Lion thing. I think that largely the baiting the lion and take him off the reservation is the biggest problem that I've got. Nonetheless, you can coordinate with all kinds of groups, hunting otherwise, if you have Cell 411.
Yes. So Cell 411 is a decentralized micro social network that allows users to manage, create, and respond to alerts and emergencies in real time. And in theory, if you are being hunted, you could send out such a notice. If you're coordinating a hunt, then Cell 411's not really used for that. You can create an unlimited number of cells or groups of users to alert in case of emergencies. If you get pulled over by police, need medical help, or if your car breaks down, you can alert a trusted group of friends or a trusted friend with your exact GPS coordinates to receive help. You will be able to know who is responding and coming to help and how far away they are. It's perfect for activists, neighborhood watchers, medical workers, and any other type of emergency responder or user concerned with police brutality problems. Send alerts in real time with your exact location or respond to alerts in real time. You will receive detailed directions to the location where your friends are located and who need help. Cell 411.
So,
stupid Apple hasn't approved it yet.
Well,
it's soon. In the Google Play Store. It's not yet approved for Apple.
When it comes to Cecil the Lion, as I understand it, the folks in Zimbabwe, there isn't as big of an uproar about Cecil there as there is here in the United States.
Because they don't have the internet?
I don't know, you know, what the specific reasons are. But, you know, for instance, I can tell you that your love of wildlife, your concern for their well-being ends when, say, a mountain lion's chewing your throat out. And large animals, especially predators, you know, predators that will kill humans, like lions will.
Grizzlies. Hey, have you ever seen the documentary Grizzly Man?
I don't think I have, no.
It's about this guy, Timothy Treadwell, who went and lived in some Alaskan wilderness reserve with the grizzly bears, and he thought that the grizzly bears had accepted him as one of their own, and he wound up getting his head chewed off by a grizzly. And you can hear in the video, unfortunately you can't see the video because the lens cap wasn't removed, but you can hear part of the video that's been released by the family where he's still trying to like talk to the grizzly, like, "You shouldn't chew my head, grizzly. Come on, just put me down." Like, he's still trying to talk lovingly to the grizzly bear that is killing him.
Yeah. Yeah, I imagine that didn't go well for him. Sorry to say. I don't think the grizzly is wrong or anything like that. I'm just saying that, you know, when you have one large predator, humans, living in close proximity to another large predator, lions, there's
and
going
tigers
to
and bears.
Oh my!
There's going to have to be a, you know, some kind of like control.
Understanding.
Yeah, and
you know, there's a show that like something like I shouldn't have survived or I shouldn't be alive.
I love
or
that
like
show.
That. Well, there was one episode of that where a guy was attacked by a bear and he survived and talks about it. And his face is all jacked up because the bear basically ate half his face off.
Yeesh.
And he just talks about that. It was just.
Let's talk to Andy calling in from Buffalo. Andy, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Oh, King Mark, as a loyal subject to reason, I kind of wanted to talk about last night when you were discussing, and I was hoping Ian would be on, but that someone against border control couldn't be libertarian.
Yeah, I don't think I took that position, right?
Right, Ian did.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Ian's of the opinion that in order to call yourself a libertarian, you must be libertarian on every issue every time, which, of course, we have another term for that. We call it voluntarist.
No, wait, you're saying that Ian took the stance. What it sounded like you just said is that Ian took the stance that if you're against border control, you're not a libertarian, which doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, well, if you're for border control, you're not a libertarian.
You're for border control.
So you're for using a governmental body, setting up and establishing a governmental body, taxing people, and you know, basically stealing money from people in order to set up an imaginary line that people can't cross, and that's libertarian.
No. What I am for is, let's say that, let's say Mark, you know, you have your pig farm, your, yep, you know, whatever you have, and let's say that we have two people who live next door to each other, and they herd sheep, and they agree, okay, we're going to share our property, and we're going to allow sheep to graze on it. And let's say that a cattle farmer moves in behind us, and all of a sudden his cattle start coming onto the sheep farm. Do we have the right to say, no, this land is for our sheep to graze on, and we've agreed?
Yeah, I think
the question is whether or not you actually own the land. And in the scenario that you gave, it's two neighbors that own the land and they let their sheep graze on the land that they both own. And yes, I would say that those two property owners have a legitimate right to say who is and is not allowed on their property. Now, the question, and I realize that you're trying to draw a comparison to immigration, but not every inch of land within what is designated as United States of America has a private land owner. And I would not say that those sheep farmers have any right to tell the cattle guy where his cattle can go on land that they do not own.
But how far does the ownership go? Can the people of Texas say, we have set up a republic here, and we would like for everyone within our republic to agree to certain rules? Now, people in Mexico, if they want to come, they have to agree to certain rules. If they agree to those rules and apply legally and don't sneak across the border, they can come in. Otherwise, if they don't agree to the rules that we, of the people of Texas, have agreed to, They cannot come in.
Would you also apply that to anyone from Oklahoma?
Let's talk about this when we come back, because I think that there's lots of points to be had here, Andy. Please hold the line if you would. The number, if you want to talk about this issue, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE, or our username is lrn.fm on Skype. Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified. For thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget freeross.org.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. Teen sex is linked to alcohol and drugs by the Center for Figuring Out Really Obvious Things. This is Doyle Redland reporting. An exhaustive four-year, $23 million study of substance abuse and sexual habits of more than 2,500 American teens has confirmed that young people between the ages of 13 and 18 who drink and or use drugs are more likely to be sexually active. Dr. Gerald Eckersley is director of the Boston-based organization.
We found that this phenomenon also occurs among adults as well as every population everywhere in the world that has ever existed since the dawn of time.
The center has sent a teleprompter-ready press release of its findings to more than 400 local TV news affiliates across the U.S., along with stock video footage of beer displays and teens smoking and drinking at parties. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is The Onion News Network.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Three seven three three. It's 855 four 50 free. King Mark the First with you.
Darryl.
And Johnson.
You can call in and talk about whatever you want. And Andy from Buffalo did just that by bringing up, well, the evergreen topic on Free Talk Live of immigration. I generally take the stance that, you know, whatever the government gets a hold of and does, it's going to mess up. So I don't want it involved in things as important as human travel. So therefore, I don't support immigration laws and controls and those sorts of things. Andy is attempting to change my mind on this one. So let's bring him back. Andy.
Oh, no, I'm totally torn on the issue because I am totally an anarchist. But it is one thing that that I really struggle with is as far as how do you set up your borders? Like I mentioned before, you know, if you're going to have two farmers that are next to each other and they're going to keep the cattle farmer off their land, how far are you going to allow people to collectivize? And then what are you going to do to stop it?
So property lines, also, I'd like to address, you made sort of two points that I think are really important. Property lines and the agreement of people within those lines about sort of the application of rules of as far as immigration goes. So an individual or, you know, a family can own some property, or just a group of people can own some property, and the lines are clearly drawn, and generally people don't dispute the ownership of that land. In the case of the United States, the ownership that the United States has over the property known as the United States, the whole big area, is dubious. They claim that with the force of violence. Now, not to say that I won't use...
That's why I really didn't go towards the ownership of the United States. I said, how about the people of the Republic of Texas?
Fine. Right, but even in Texas, there's a lot of property that is not owned by any individual person that is claimed to be owned by either the government of Texas... Or right now, there's also a large amount of land that is claimed to be owned by the U.S. government. So that there's land that no one properly claims ownership of. So I would say that no one has the right to tell someone that they can't be on land that no one owns.
But what if the population of Texas swelled to the point where it was all claimed? Could they at that point say to the people of Mexico, you cannot cross this line?
I think that individual property owners could say, you can't come onto my property, but you would have absolutely zero right to tell anybody that they cannot come to my property.
Right. If I lived in Texas, I do not. But, you know, if the people of New Hampshire could decide for whatever reason, 51% of them could decide, and you probably could get 51% of people in just about every state to agree, no new folks, especially them folks don't speak right. You can probably get that to happen. But that doesn't change the fact that I should be able to have visitors to my property that I want to have come visit. And that the 51% of the people in a given geographic area should not be able to tell me who can come visit me. And that is
the issue. But if a group of farmers that occupy the entire area along the border between Mexico and Texas say you are not allowed to come and stead on our property... Are they allowed to then do that?
As long as they don't use the force of government to keep people from using airplanes to fly over that piece of property.
Or use boats to go through the Gulf of Mexico.
If somebody bought... Hold on.
I mean, because as far as libertarians go, we're supposed to agree that it's up to arbitration. So if the arbiters agree that, okay, this land is now owned by this collective of farmers. I mean, let's say it's spread across the border, and an arbiter agrees that this area of land is owned by these farmers, and those people are not allowed to, and the farmers agree, we don't want
I got the idea,
people
Andy.
On our land because we're going to farm it. Are they allowed to cross it?
Andy, if I buy all the property around your house, am I allowed to prevent you from leaving? And I shoot down every helicopter that comes by. Are you then my slave?
That's the dilemma. Then
it is not a dilemma. You cannot enslave people with your property.
Because am I now? Do I now own my property?
Yes, you own your property.
You own my right to get to my property.
You cannot prevent somebody from getting to your property. There's things called rights of way, and people have to be able to egress and on and off of their property. And
so that deletes your argument.
What do you mean?
Well, you said, can you buy up all the property around my property and prevent me from accessing it?
No. If my intention is to enslave people, then you can't do that.
How are you enslaving people in Mexico by just simply telling them you cannot cross my property?
You aren't allowing... you aren't allowing them to take airplanes. You aren't allowing them to take boats and go around. You're saying, oh, I guess just a bunch of other people that I voted for said that.
No. You're just not allowed to cross onto that area. You can certainly go around it. I mean, people can certainly right now go take a boat from Mexico to Canada. They can take a boat from Mexico to Alaska.
The question here was whether or not this is...
From Mexico to China.
Yeah, but the question here is whether or not this was a libertarian thing to believe in or not. So, what you're saying...
Right. Can you, as a libertarian, believe in borders?
You can believe in property rights, which property by natural...
collectivize those borders?
And that's where you run into a problem, is when you collectivize anything. Well,
that is the dilemma.
Well, wait, but here's the thing. It's not really a dilemma. Libertarianism is an individualist philosophy. It's not a collectivist philosophy. So the moment you start to collectivize things, sure, yes. Can you collectivize property if everyone agrees? If every single person on that property agrees? Sure. But when you start having groups of people that are electing to say, 49% of Texas is really okay with having an open border and letting people go across, but they can be damned because we voted.
No, I'm talking about the collectivization of private property when you have a bunch of farmers.
But you aren't.
No,
next door to each other, and they each agree. Now, they each have their own private property, and I'm not talking about a 51% vote. I'm talking about a 100% vote where every single one of those farmers agrees. We are now part of a collective where we are going to, at 100% levels, not a 51% vote, not a democracy, not two wolves and a sheep voting on what's for dinner. We all agree. We are going to have this property, we are going to maintain it, and we are not going to allow anyone onto it unless they agree to our rules. Now, those are borders. Are those libertarian?
No, they're not, because there's all kinds of extra things that go with it. A person from Mexico cannot travel
against what you were arguing with Ian.
Yeah, I don't know that you're right there, Mark. I disagree with you on this.
Okay, well, let me tell if somebody buys all the property around my house, am I allowed to leave?
You shouldn't be in a place where everyone can buy all the property around your house.
Well, we currently have roads and stuff. there's private the state of New Hampshire.
Right, those are enforced by the government.
Right, and that's really the issue here is the government. You almost never have a situation where somebody's actually hemmed in and cannot travel by private property because the state throws off this scenario.
Right, I guess my point was basically just Ian, and I'll probably call back in when he's on. The fact that he is saying that you cannot be libertarian and agree that you can have borders. And I would say that if myself and a whole bunch of my friends bought up 3/4 of Texas and we agreed 100%, we owned our property. And unless you agreed to certain rules, you
make
can't
it,
come on our property.
Make a note when you talk to Ian, make a note of that 100% ownership.
Right, and it's also incredibly not realistic to think that a handful of people could buy every inch of property along the Rio Grande River.
We're talking theory. And he said, because a lot of libertarianism is theory.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what. Commercials aren't theories. See you later. I got to go, Andy. 855-450-3733.
Seven nights a week.
855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Well, it's kind of, I don't know if we've been derailed entirely, but I still have this article about Cecil the Lion. Seems to be the big story on social media today. And we just had a caller call in and talk about sort of property rights and immigration and how those things fit together. So, you know, hey, either one of those, fine by me. If you want to talk about them, let's go. 855-450-FREE, or potentially you can call in and talk about whatever you want. Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in cryptocurrency ecosystem. Bitcoinist is the prime online destination for information about the Bitcoin and digital currency industry. Their website integrates a community forum, breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. They also aim to cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Bitcoinist has a very sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics and a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin. And much more. Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies. From beginners to experts, it's bitcoinist.net. Let's go to Jonathan, calling from Atlanta, listening via podcast. Jonathan, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, what's up? Hopefully we can keep getting some callers in here so we don't talk about this stupid line. That would be awesome. But I want to jump on the bandwagon of bashing Ian again. I really wish he was there tonight. Day after the border conversation, y'all went into a conversation on defining libertarian, and Ian was really getting on my nerves. But I want to discuss something that Conan said.
What was it specifically? You need to sort of let folks know what was bothering you that Ian was saying.
Yeah. Well, no, the fact now I know every movement we need our purists, but just how Ian was just saying that unless you get every single issue right in his eyes, you can't wear the title libertarian.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
And yeah, it's absolutely ridiculous. I think I know Ian is 100 times the activist that I'll ever be, probably. And
he's probably
drawn more people to the movement than I ever will. But if you're going to draw these harsh lines on what a libertarian is, I think you're going to push more people away than you're going to draw people in.
So let me ask this question before you continue. What percentage should someone be in order to use the term libertarian? So if somebody is like 90%.
If you go off of like what Walter Block says when he grades politicians, Walter Block won't necessarily say Rand Paul is a libertarian, but he gave him a 70% grade.
Rand Paul won't even say that Rand Paul's a libertarian.
Rand Paul has said that he comes from the libertarian wing of the party. I mean, come on.
But he also says, I am not a libertarian.
Right.
He said that numerous times. He said the media thought they could hang that word around my neck like an albatross. It's not true. I'm not a libertarian. I'm a libertarian-leaning Republican.
Okay, but regardless, I'm just saying how Walter Block has called him or agrees he's not a libertarian but has given him like a 70% grade. So, I mean,
my answer is 80%.
You want to go with.
My answer is 80%.
I think that would be fair.
I've heard some people try to expand the word libertarian to be everybody but Barack Obama and Adolf Hitler.
Okay, fine. They can go as far as they want. I'm going to argue against it.
I mean, so will I.
I would say 80%. It has some, for me, it has some momentum. So if you get an 80-80 on the world's smallest political quiz, you'll rank libertarian in the Nolan chart.
Yes.
If you if the Republican Liberty Caucus, when it was ranking politicians, it would call a politician that got 80% libertarian votes a libertarian. And there were very few that did, but a few. Now, I think it's generous in many cases, and a lot of times I disagree with these politicians on some major issues. I didn't like that ranking system, but they did use 80%. So for me, the number 80, I like it. Because, the reason I choose not to use 100% is we have a word for that. The word for that we use is voluntarist. Some people use other words to describe it, consensualist. They'll use the term anarchist or anarcho-capitalist and use a variety of other terms that don't have much meaning to me. But the reason, libertarian means it's a wider tent. I don't believe it includes everybody who's libertarian on one issue, because everybody's libertarian on one issue.
Right. That's how Bill Maher is able to claim that he's a libertarian, though he advocates for gun control, strict immigration, and a bunch of other horrible things.
Bill Maher is able to claim he's a libertarian because he has lips. And that's the only reason, right? Like, you can claim to be a libertarian and not be libertarian enough for me, too. And so I would love to have, conversations. I want people to identify as a libertarian. That way I can attempt to use tie-down methods. You say you're libertarian, You believe that the government's inefficient in certain ways. Can we agree that the government's inefficient in this area that you want the government to work? And if we can, is there a way that the free market can solve this problem better than the government?
Boy, you know, it's this whole thing of Rand Paul, you know, it's I love the fact Facebook's new search. So I was able to just real quick right now, I just did a little search about posts that I've made over the past few years, posts by me about Rand Paul, just to see what I've been saying about Rand Paul, because I hated Rand Paul for a long time. So I just wanted to see, like, what issues, you know, that I've been talking about. So, you know, Rand Paul talking about wanting drones within the United States borders to enforce security. Rand Paul talking about how he doesn't have sympathy for Manning, Bradley
or
Manning.
Snowden.
Or Snowden. Rand Paul assuring evangelicals that he does not want to end the drug war. Rand Paul supporting Ted Cruz and Jim DeMint and Romney.
And Mitch McConnell.
Hey, do you think the things that Rand Paul says are more important than the way he votes?
Rand Paul endorsed Ted Cruz.
Okay. Yeah, and I didn't support that either.
Yeah.
So, Johnson, I've asked you a question. Is it more important to you what Rand Paul says or how he votes?
Both, I think,
are important. Oh, definitely how he votes.
So when he voted for sanctions on Iran, was that a pro-liberty vote that he took?
Or when he voted no on GMO labeling, or when he voted yes for the NDAA?
I think that he is, by his votes, the most libertarian senator.
Yeah, and that's like saying that somebody has the least smelly poo.
I won the Special Olympics.
I would like to deal with the least smelly poo when we're talking about politicians. None of them are going to be perfect, and the guy's running for office. So, whatever.
I don't know. I've consistently wrote in Mary Ruart several times. So
feel free. Write in Captain America if you wish. Thanks for the call, Jonathan. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
I wrote in Mary Ruart one time when she wasn't even running.
She's, I'm sure she's not perfect either when it comes to these issues. Whenever you vote for an individual, a person, they're going to let you down.
Sure, but you know what my lowest bar of standard is? It's going to be a Michael Bednarik. That's my lowest bar of standard.
I voted for him. I guess I rooted for him. I didn't actually vote for him. I was disenfranchised in that election.
I want an extremely strict constitutionalist. You know what's a low bar standard for me? Ron Paul. That's a low standard for me.
Let's go to Chris calling in from Maine. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind? Chris, can you hear me now?
I can hear you.
Excellent. What's on your mind?
Earlier you had a post, earlier today you had a post about transgender bathrooms.
Oh, yeah, we did. We had a Free Talk Live's Facebook page, facebook.freetalklive.com. You can get there easily, facebook.freetalklive.com. We posted something, I don't know, it was a picture of a bathroom thing, and instead of, it's like all genders are welcome or something bathroom, and it has a picture of a man, a woman, a baby floating in space, and this figure that was both that appeared to be like half man, half woman from the figure, like, you know, just okay. Sticking the two together.
Right.
So what do you got to say about it, Chris?
Well, I mean, there seemed to be some concern about violence and stuff like that on the responses.
Yeah.
And I'd be curious. I mean, so many people are talking about opposite gender violence, but what about same gender violence, among other things?
Like?
Or similar. Like, you know, in a traditional situation, you know, woman on a woman violence or man on a man violence or whatever.
Yeah, I would think that if a transgendered person was forced to go into a, a man that dresses like a woman has to go into the men's bathroom, there's probably a chance of violence against that person. I'll hold on to you. I'd like to talk to you about this a bit more if you're interested, Chris.
Yep.
855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. What do we do about transgendered folks going potty?
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most.
StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaqettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting.
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Ha ha.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, July 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.66 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,085 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $289. Antiwar.com reports once again seeking to reassure the Senate Armed Services Committee that the Iran deal won't get in the way of a potential U.S. attack on Iran. Secretary of Defense Ash Carter yesterday insisted the deal provides no limits to U.S. attacks and that the U.S. has such a robust amount of military force in the area they can hit anywhere in Iran at any time. Carter has repeatedly talked up the idea of the U.S. following on to the nuclear deal with a unilateral military strike on Iran for some unspecified reason, and presented the notion multiple times in the week after the deal's announcement, during which he visited Israel and sought to assure them that war was still in the works. Joint Chiefs of Staff Chairman General Martin Dempsey appeared to talk back the notion of a sudden attack, however, declaring in his own testimony that a U.S. attack on Iran would be an act of war, while going to great lengths to avoid taking a position on the wisdom of launching such a war. Dempsey and other officials also presented as part of the narrative on the deal that it makes war less likely, a talking point for the administration, which doesn't seem to be sitting well with many in Congress, for whom a massive new war is an end unto itself. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports three former members of the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity at the University of Virginia filed a defamation lawsuit against Rolling Stone on Wednesday for a now-retracted article the magazine published about a gang rape. In April, Rolling Stone officially retracted an article written by Sabrina Erdely, which told of the rape of a University of Virginia student identified as Jackie at a party at the Phi Kappa Psi fraternity house. Fraternity members denied any wrongdoing, and Charlottesville, Virginia police said there was no evidence to support the story. But
but months passed between when the story was published and when it was officially walked back. During that time, three former members of the fraternity said people identified them as being involved in fictitious rapes based on details in the story. George Elias IV, Stephen Hadford, and Ross Fowler filed a lawsuit Wednesday in U.S. District Court in New York, accusing Rolling Stone and Erdely of defamation. The lawsuit also names Winner Media. The lawsuit says Rolling Stone and Erdely were negligent for relying on just one source, Jackie, for the story, citing a report by the Columbia School of Journalism, which called the article a journalistic failure. When her plush and comfy life suddenly and unexpectedly fell apart, Brooke and her dog Cloud set out to defy the odds. If this is a man's world, as they say, living on the streets is no place for a young woman. One day she awoke in the Redwood Forest and realized she had become a hobo, and would ultimately come to know exactly what it means to survive. How to Be a Hobo by Brooke Willett is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores. Reuters reports a New York State court on Wednesday declined to release details of a grand jury investigation that led to a police officer being cleared of wrongdoing in the death of Eric Garner after his chokehold arrest in Staten Island in July last year. Lawyers for civil rights groups and New York's public advocate office in June called for the release of the grand jury minutes, including transcripts of testimony, exhibits, and details of certain grand jurors to better understand the decision not to charge Officer Daniel Pantaleo for Garner's death. The lawyers did not establish a compelling reason for disclosure of the minutes, according to the Appellate Division of New York State Supreme Court. The ruling said the public interest in preserving grand jury secrecy outweighed the public interest in disclosure. Concern for the safety of grand jurors and the potential to compromise an ongoing federal investigation into the incident were also cited as reasons not to release the details. New York City earlier this month agreed to pay Garner's family $5.9 million to resolve the claim over his death.
Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com.
This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Thomas the Tank Engine says he's a little uneasy with his broad autistic following, and a couple has a nest egg of debt to make sure they've got some money to owe down the road. This is the Onion Week in Review. Local video editor James Korf told reporters Wednesday that despite having said goodbye over 10 minutes ago, his friend, Michael Woodward, still remained active on GChat and had shown no signs of leaving.
If it were yellow, it would mean that he hasn't been on the computer for a little while, or if it was red, it would mean he doesn't want to talk, but it's green. I can tell. I can see it right there.
Korf later said that he felt briefly relieved when Woodward's chat logo turned orange, but was once again dejected when it became green within seconds. And in this week's op-ed pages, a high school guidance counselor laments the fact that no one in his entire damn school has been molested. In other news, a bed bug feels bad for an area man, but a bug's gotta eat. A development exec wants to see what, where, and how that would look, live, and play out. And a man at the gym is just watching TV. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. Chris has just called in with another evergreen topic. If we let the transgenders do what they want, where do they go potty? And, you know, I mean, it's whatever we've got to say about this topic, people wonder. And it is something, it's, you know, it's something we're going to have to confront. So let's bring Chris back on and talk about this subject a little bit more. Chris, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Excellent. So I guess... what I would say that the generally you're finding bathrooms out there that as new buildings are being built, they'll build these things called like the family room for people to go potty. But it's the old buildings that have to be kind of re-outfitted that I think that is the biggest concern.
For me also, I grew up camping and boating.
Yep.
So I am used to, so we say, somewhat tight living conditions.
Okay.
And so someone, you know, doing their thing right next to where I'm sleeping is no big deal to me.
All right.
So I'm like, whatever. You know, who
cares? It's just another body.
Yep.
So basically that was my thing. I thought that the discussion of the focus on the like the man danger thing was a little bit overdone.
Yeah, I think that there's something, an argument to be made, right? Like that, you know, men are more dangerous than women when it comes to acts of violence, and it doesn't matter whether they're against men or against women, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so if you force transgendered men to go use the men's bathroom, they're liable to get beaten up in there. However, if you let men just go into the women's bathroom because they self-identify, you know, some guy says, I put a beret in my hair. Now I'm going to the women's bathroom, and I'm going to see what's going on in there. And acting just plain old weird, don't tell me it's not going to happen, because it's going to happen. I think that these things...
You don't need, you know, special regulations allowing people to go potty where they decide that they want to go potty for, you know, people to assault one another. Like, that's just an excuse of, well, if we have this regulation, then these assaults are going to happen. Like, assaults happen anyway. Assault is still illegal if you let a man that identifies as a woman go potty in the women's room.
Yeah.
I don't disagree with that. And I would say that transgendered folks have been around for decades.
Yes.
And they've been figuring out where they're going to go potty reasonably well. I'd say that mostly what you're dealing with here is how well does somebody pass? If you're doing a reasonably good job of looking like a woman, I don't think anybody's going to give you a problem going in the women's bathroom. If you're doing a reasonably good job of looking like a man, fine, you're going to the men's bathroom. I mean, I'm not interested in the potty police, people running around and going, I think that there's a man in here. You know, like, oh, really? Come on, is he bothering you? Because I think that you got stalls and stuff, and it should be okay, right? But man,
now
vipers.
let me give you some sort of insight that not
Please
a lot of people.
Please give me the
people...
insight on the trans stuff, Darryl.
No, not on that. About bathroom cleanliness, because I was a janitor for a while at a big box store here in Keene, and this particular big box store had three primary bathrooms. They had the men's room, the women's room, and then the family bathroom that had one toilet, and it was a good bit bigger, had a slightly larger baby changing area. The toilet room that was the cleanest was the family room. The one that was the dirtiest was the women's room.
Really?
So yes.
The women's? Okay.
Because women...
I've heard that.
Women don't like to sit down on the toilet seats when they use the bathroom, especially when they're going number two.
I've heard you can get pregnant from those things.
So there were times when I would go in and there would be defecate on the handle and on the wall, and I have no clue how that happens, but it was a very regular occurrence. So my solution is a bunch of single stall bathrooms that anybody can go in.
That'll handle it. Chris, thanks for the call.
Yep, thank you.
Yep.
And then you don't have bathrooms to worry. And then you don't have to worry about what someone identifies as. It's just, do you identify as a human that uses a toilet? Then this room is for you.
I think the floors and walls and toilets and stalls should all be made of metal, and in between people leaving the bathroom, the whole room should just be coated in fire. clean the whole thing.
So the fire would not actually clean it. It would burn the defecate onto the metal.
Or it would scorch it off, you know, just hot enough, you know, like just.
I knew what I was doing when I posted this this piece of clickbait, as it were, on Free Talk Live's Facebook page, because I know my audience. If I put up this picture of this sort of transgendered figure saying all gender restroom, I know that I'm going to pit the righties against the lefties on the Free Talk Live page, and they're going to go at it like gladiators. I'm not a fool. And at this point, I think that just looking at it here, You know, it's reached nothing huge for mine, but I guess this wasn't a real winner. 3,200 people have been reached. I know a lot of pages would kill for those numbers. I consider those small. That's 6% below my average, as a matter of fact. So I guess this wasn't the winner I thought it was going to be.
But it's only been up for a couple of hours, and there's a bunch of other stuff that people are all up in arms about. People are still sharing the stuff about the dentist that killed the lion.
Yep.
And I want to know. You have to make sure to mention that he's a dentist, because dentists are mean, horrible, evil people that like to cause pain.
I want to know, what is clickbait? Because people will post this sometimes on some of the stories I post. They'll go, clickbait! And I don't care if you click on the article that I post.
Okay, but clickbait is, you've seen these things to where
15 stupid things we're going to list that are you're going to have to click 30 times to read all of them, right? That thing where they make a list and
you
then
won't believe number 4 also there's what I love calling the sort of Mad Lib thing, to where blank did blank. You'll never imagine what happened later.
Yeah. I don't do that. I do post articles that say that, but I will say generally in the post what it is about, because I don't particularly like that. I don't want to have to click through to find out. And I won't post any article that has a list where you have to scroll through a list,
hate that. And that's one of the reasons that I absolutely avoid the Austin Peterson website, libertarianrepublic.com.
He knows, but what he knows is that he gets more clicks, he gets more views. More views mean more money, and that's all that is. So, you know, whatever.
That, and also he's a lot more Republic than Libertarian, so that's another reason to avoid the site.
Whatever he's doing, I think he's put some good articles out. But nonetheless, people use this term clickbait on my articles, and it's not clickbait, dude. It's not clickbait. It is interaction bait, or, you know, like, share, comment bait. Because that's what I want from you. I don't care whether you look at my article. All I care is if you comment on it. And I'd like you to make an intelligent comment, but if you don't, that reflects on you, not me.
Hold on, you're wanting people to have intelligent conversations on Facebook?
What I want them to do is to get wound up and call in like Chris did. I want them to call in on the subject so that I'm actually getting people to, you know, interact on, you know, call in on different issues on Free Talk Live. Most of them are pansies, and they will say whatever they say on Facebook, but they won't take the time or energy, or they haven't got the guts to call in and talk about it, because that's what I don't believe you can hold somebody responsible on a message forum, which Facebook is to me. I don't think you can have a real conversation, really get to the heart of an issue, because people are constantly talking past each other.
Right, so, and then people don't read all of the previous comments where you already answered the question that the first guy asked, and then the 7th, and then the 49th guy.
And that's why I almost never comment after I post the story. Why should I? You're not paying attention anyway. 855-450-3733. You want to tell me what clickbait is? 855-450-FREE. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
At 30dayfoodsupply.com, two of our top priorities are providing quality food at a reasonable price and protecting your security. When you call 800-700-2184, we will never record your phone call and never ask for your personal information, like how much food you have stored or where you keep it. We'll also never store your credit card information and email address on a computer. Your email address will never be shared or sold. We'll never limit the number of boxes you can purchase. We'll never use outside packers or use relabeled food from another company. Our meals are naturally high in fiber, carbs, and protein, and everything is packed with oxygen absorbers and Mylar pouches under our direct supervision at our plant in Oregon. Oregon Trail Foods and 30dayfoodsupply.com keep prices low by buying directly from their producers in Oregon and then passing the savings on to you. Call 800-700-2184 and purchase our 30-day 90-serving emergency food supply for only $99, and $10 ships your entire order to the lower 48. Visit our website, 30dayfoodsupply.com, or call 800-700-2184. That's 30dayfoodsupply.com at 800-700-2184.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. We still have this article about Cecil the Lion that I want to finish up here. It's Mark with you.
Darryl.
And Johnson.
ProXPN, because you need to protect yourself online. Your internet service providers likely saving your surfing history. Criminals are sniffing your Wi-Fi packets. Governments and corporations are limiting what you can see on the internet, not to mention the NSA sweeping up all your data. ProXPN can solve all of that. Simply download the app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, even Linux. Go through their easy setup and then just connect to the internet, and you're protected from all of it. No more prying, no more spying. One account works for all your devices. You don't have to have a separate account for each device. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you get 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with our code. It's FTL50. That's like $5 a month. That's for the lifetime of the account. You don't have to, it doesn't matter which premium account you go with. You still save. With the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth with servers all around the world to access, the ability to privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and ProXPN doesn't keep records of your online habits. You get all that with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. It's proxpn.com/FTL, promo code FTL50.
Hunters hacking into your GPS data. You don't want them to know about that stuff.
You don't want that. So, going on here with this article from Gizmodo regarding the dentist that hunted this lion, Cecil. And he's making points, and I think they're really important ones, because this isn't an issue that people seem to be applying a great deal of rationality to, and I want to apply that. And then there's trophy hunting, which, full disclosure, I think is dumb, but it because it attaches a large economic incentive to the continued presence of animals and that often live in conflict with us humans. It contributes to, if not outright ensures, their survival. Let's look at why that is. First, are there numbers that back this up? Can the link between high-dollar trophy hunting of endangered species and their conservation be qualified? Conservation Magazine studied the issue and found, according to a 2005 paper by Nigel Leader Williams and colleagues in the Journal of International Wildlife Law and Policy, the answer is yes. Leaders Williams described how the legislation of white rhinoceros hunting in South Africa motivated private landowners to reintroduce the species onto their lands. As a result, the country saw an increase of white rhinos from fewer than 100 individuals to more than 11,000, even while a limited number were killed as trophies. That's it. Trophy hunters have more of a vested interest in the animals than you do, because
they want to make sure that it's alive. Like, if somebody could reanimate a brontosaurus or bronchiosaur, because brontosaurus didn't actually exist or whatever, but if somebody could, like, you know, reanimate these things, I guarantee you there would be some hunters that would say, I want to go kill me a brontosaurus. And somebody would make sure that they breed the brontosaurus so that somebody could go kill a brontosaurus.
Yeah, and then somebody on the internet who has no financial stake whatsoever would cry about it. They would spend an inordinate amount of time of their day going, the brontosaurus. And this is really the point.
Do you think that there would be regulations against, like, if it had to be like, you know, you have a bow and arrow and you maximum you can have four guys, and it's a Tyrannosaurus Rex hunt. Do you think that there would be, right, like, the government would be like, no, you can't do that.
All right, I
think
so
somebody's going to die.
So hold on. I've got questions about the Tyrannosaurus Rex hunt.
Was the Tyrannosaurus Rex fed cocaine first?
Does it have a laser mounted to its forehead?
That's definitely a question that I did not think. But no, like, how old is the Tyrannosaurus? And that's a very important question, because Tyrannosaurus, much like all lizard-type creatures, will grow, and actually all reptiles, for that matter, will grow as long as they are alive.
Right.
So, like, back before, you know, the comet came down and, like, you know, all the dinosaurs died, we don't know how long Tyrannosaurus lived to wind up to be 20 foot tall.
Maybe their lifespan is like turtles. They live 200 years.
Right. So, you know, is that a 1,000-year-old Tyrannosaurus, or is it like a 12-year-old Tyrannosaurus that's maybe only like 4.5 feet tall?
You also have to take into consideration what is the sort of the societal structure of the Tyrannosauri. So, for instance, lions, what they don't mention here is that Cecil is responsible for the great deal of deaths of male lions, because Cecil was in charge of his pride, and there was not a single other male lion above a certain age in his pride. They were driven out by Cecil. And by killing Cecil, what they have allowed to do is allowed genetic diversity to be entered into the pride. Now, I'm not saying that that's good or bad. I don't know.
All right. So I just want to go on record before this conversation continues any further and say that I think that Cecil the Lion was an a-hole.
Well, I can tell you just about every male lion is an a-hole. If you apply the standards that humans have for behavior, nobody likes the male lions except that they're pretty. And, you know, I mean, they're not particularly hard workers. They
make the women do all the work.
They make the women do all the work.
Lion phalluses are barbed, like, with spikes, essentially.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, that's got to be
just
really
going to be unpleasant.
That's a blast. And they drive away all the other males. They can't have. And if they co-opt another pride, they kill all the babies of the previous male that was there. So, Cecil, not such a great guy. And
so hold on. So what you're telling me is there's a major plot hole in The Lion King, because Scar never would have been alive if Mufasa's pride was run like the way a real lion pride is run.
You know, I don't know much about The Lion King. I think I saw it once a long time ago. And, you know, I'm sure I was enjoyed it. And I'm sure that this is half the reason that Cecil's popular right now, is because people think he's Simba. But no, I don't really
remember. And then speaking of plot holes in Disney movies, there's a huge plot hole in Finding Nemo. Because clownfish are hermaphroditic, and the largest clownfish in the school is always a female. The second largest is always a male, meaning that when the largest dies, that means the female dies, the second largest, which was a male, transforms into a woman. So Nemo's father should have been his mother.
Right, turned into a woman.
Well, there may not
Maybe his father was transitioning at the time.
There may not be a plot hole in the studio, but there is a hole of some sort. Let's go on with the studio. Let's go on with this story here. The author says, what's going on here? There is that a specific economic incentive was introduced that benefited the white rhino population. Yes, this resulted in some being killed and turned into the world's most morbid umbrella stands or whatever. But by and large, the white rhino population was able to recover from the brink of extinction specifically because of trophy hunting. Your social media outrage didn't save the white rhino in South Africa. A-holes like Walt Palmer did. And this is what the irrational bedwetters on Facebook just don't get. If you're answering with your emotions, you don't get it. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Bah! All right, so suddenly Walmart, eBay, Amazon, everybody wants to ban the rebel flag. Well, the rebel flag is an important part of American history. The rebel flag is still a long-standing symbol of Southern pride and Southern heritage. So if the big retailers want to play into political correctness and try to deny the history of America, let them. Go to ourflags.com. That's R, like rebel, R, the letter R. Ourflags.com. Get your rebel flag before they actually do outlaw the things, huh? Ourflags.com. That's ourflags.com. Go now.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service, and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. It's Mark with you.
Darryl.
And Johnson.
855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. I would be remiss if I did not mention that the prices of precious metals right now are at near a five-year low.
Woohoo!
And that means it's could be a good time to purchase some gold and silver. I think it is, and I have made moves in that regard. Can't have all your eggs in one basket, you know. So, you can choose to do what I've done, or you can do whatever you want. But if you're looking for gold and silver, please check out gold.freetalklive.com, because I've worked with Midas Resources for a very long time, and you can trust them. They do great business. They have good prices. And we, Free Talk Live gets a little spiff in the process. So it's gold.freetalklive.com to get your precious metals. Going on with the article from Gizmodo about this Walt Palmer dentist fellow that shot Cecil the Lion. Conservation and hunting have long gone hand in hand. Noted big game hunter Teddy Roosevelt is widely considered the originator of the modern conservation movement, thanks to his acknowledgement that managed use for profit, rather than simply setting aside vast tracts of land for no purpose but preservation, was a viable model for protecting our natural heritage. Teddy famously stated, "The nation behaves well if it treats the natural resources as assets, which it must turn over to the next generation, increased and not impaired in value. Conservation means development as much as it does protection." Bully. What he and conservationists found was that to justify its existence in the harsh reality of the human world, nature needed to be economically justify its existence. Today, trophy hunting takes place in 23 sub-Saharan African nations, generating over 200 million and attracting over 18,000 clients each year. That's money spent in the economies of multiple African nations directly pegged to the continuing presence of big game animals. It's a large economic incentive for conservation of these species, and it's growing. This chart from a study conducted by the University of Pretoria demonstrates the increased economic value of trophy hunting in southern Africa. The explosive growth in South Africa is largely due to ranch land, which has been dedicated to livestock, being given over to game ranching. So there are people in South Africa that have found that it is more profitable to keep lions on their property than it is to keep cattle. And that's because, you know, beef's a competitive business. There's constantly...
I'm just sitting here thinking, like,
thank you to LRN.FM. I'm opening a game company here in Cameroon.
I hope Akko can do that. I really do. I have no idea. Like, the thing about Africa is it's this giant continent. It's not all covered with zebras or whatever, right? We don't know anything. In the United States, we know nothing of Africa.
Right. You know? I know. There's not at all.
The biggest desert in the world is there. There's the dark parts that don't have, because, you know, elephants don't live in the jungle. They run around on the savannah.
How do you know? Oh. Have you been to the Congo? There might be some tiny elephants running around in there.
Little tiny elephant. I'm sure they're very cute. Anyway, I'm just
saying.
Reason.com
just did a great video piece on Africa, specifically South Africa, about certain economies there being, you know, sort of less managed economies, and just how massively quickly that they are growing compared to the rest of the world because they're free,
less managed
free economies, that they're just, some of these economies in South Africa are the fastest growing economies in the world.
But generally when it comes to wildlife management, it tends to have better results. So let's go on here. Because a hunter like Walt Palmer is prepared to fly over and pay someone a large sum of money to kill a big endangered critter, an economic opportunity attached to that critter is created. So, an enterprising individual will do anything from breeding to fostering to protecting and or providing a habitat for a population of those critters. In order for that economic opportunity to last and for the investment to pay off, many more critters need to be added than the Walts of this world can ever kill. And because Walt and his pals want prime examples of that critter hanging around on their trophy room walls, those critters need to be happy, healthy, and wild. Yes, Walt will kill some of them, but many more will be able to go about their happy, healthy, wild lives as a result. Yes, most of Walt's spending does get pocketed by greedy capitalist types. But that's the entire idea here. The greedy capitalist types are the ones earning a profit off the happy, healthy, wild population of critters. This isn't some government boondoggle. It's capitalism at its finest.
And I think I can say this safely to the audience that's listening to this program. Look at the philosophy of the people who jump on board to hating these types of things. People like PETA, right? These are people that are generally the type of people that hate capitalism.
They're green on the
outside humans.
And red on the inside like a watermelon.
Yeah, and they hate humans, as clearly evidenced by Ingrid Newkirk's call for this guy to be killed, which doesn't make any logical sense whatsoever. And they generally are the type of people that also hate capitalism.
I've heard some of these environmentalists say that for the planet to survive, humanity needs to go extinct. And my response is, okay, you first.
Well, the planet's going to do just fine. Anybody that's had to mow the lawn in the summer, anybody who's let their lawn go for too long knows that the planet is going to do just fine. I don't care what humans do to it. We're not worried about the planet. You might be worried about charismatic megafauna like Cecil here, and that's a valid thing to be concerned with. What you need to do is do some investigation and see that it's big game hunters, which are the ones that are most responsible. Right. Now, I don't know if
it's not going to be lions and deer that shoot the asteroids out of the sky that would potentially wipe out half, you know, like the population of the planet.
Right. The dinosaurs were never able to do that, right? The dinosaurs had been smart enough to build a big laser to shoot the asteroid that supposedly killed them all, then they'd still be here.
No, instead we're going to have Elon Musk building a Hyperloop space elevator that goes up and then we mine the asteroids. That's what's going to happen.
Maybe the dinosaurs were the ones that actually built the pyramids in Egypt, and they thought that the pyramids were lasers to shoot the asteroids, but they were wrong.
That's helpful. So
no, and there's actually some old Egyptian text about the Egyptians discovering the Sphinx, not building it. So somebody or something built it. I'm not saying it was aliens. I'm saying it was dinosaurs.
How does the economic impact of hunting compare to tourism? After all, some tourists are paying to see animals, thereby giving them the economic value, too. In 2013, all tourism, not just people seeing animals, netted the South African economy $5.8 billion, which is a lot more money than hunting brings in. But that hunting is taking place in areas where tourists don't often go. Game ranches have reached an equivalent total area to the national parks in South Africa, effectively doubling the land on which large animals have to grow and roam. Trophy hunting is also present in countries which do not otherwise have significant tourist economies, like Ethiopia, Chad. Who's ever heard of, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to spend the summer in Chad.
I heard somebody say that one time, but she was referring to some guy on the Jersey Shore.
The Central African Republic, and again, providing economic incentive for the conservation of animals that otherwise might not exist in struggling economies and through political instability. The average tourist in South Africa spends $64 a day on stuff like food and hotel rooms and transportation and maybe a tour of the national park. It costs a hunter up to $35,000 to kill a single lion in that country. How does that economic benefit of hunting compare to the money provided by charities? The World Wildlife Fund, for instance, spends $224 million a year. But that's spread across the globe on programs in inducing deforestation, habitat destruction, and curbing carbon emissions. Some spin on anti-poaching initiative, but it doesn't equal the economic incentive for conservation in Africa that trophy hunting does. And still comment on Cecil the Lion, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live or LRN.FM on Skype, 855-450-FREE.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates, or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education, or maybe one the U.S. News and World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence, includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Yeah! Free Talk Live!
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's King Mark the First,
Darryl,
and Johnson.
855-450-FREE. We're going to finish up this article here on trophy hunting. They're using Cecil the Lion as a foil here to talk in a rational manner about trophy hunting and what it means to the African economies and the world.
Dentist.
Yeah, dentist. You have to see the word dentist whenever you talk about this guy that has killed Cecil the Lion. So, going on with the article here from Gizmodo, trophy hunting's also a powerful anti-poaching tool. If an animal is worth a large sum of money, which, you know, they say $55,000 is what he paid to kill this lion, the people invested in earning that sum of money are motivated to prevent losses. That doesn't, if I had a $55,000 animal, I'm going to take very good care of that animal. They were hunting all kinds of, This doesn't help national parks where hunting is all kinds of forbidden, but it does prevent the illegal taking of protected species on private land. And we're really, does it matter where animals are protected as long as we have these animals? I mean, nobody's crying over the, you know, God knows how many tens of thousands of cattle that are killed every year in every day in America.
I would say that it does matter where they're killed or where they're protected, because if they're killed on private property, then the owners of that private property, if they're, you know, like in this case, they're the people that are basically running these come kill our animal things, those people have an interest in making sure that only people who have paid them money kill their animals. In the government-run national parks and government-run wildlife preserves, there's not really any incentive to make sure that the animal stays alive.
Also, these private animal shooting places are very good at protecting their animals.
Yes.
The parks are very bad.
Yes.
So, going on. Walt has been photographed with at least one lion kill previous to the one that caused the current furor. It's been reported that he paid up to $55,000 for this latest hunt. That's at least $100,000 that he's personally put into African economies, money that wouldn't have been spent there if it weren't for lions to hunt. That's money.
Which we've already heard from Akko about how much like that translates into a massive amount
right.
of money.
Right. $100,000 in Africa is a heck of a lot more than $100,000 in the United States. That's money which is a specific economic motivation for conservation. So how much money would you have you and your Facebook friends contributed directly to big game conservation in Africa? Anybody? Answer this question for me. If you were complaining about the shooting of this lion, how much money have you given to conservation in Africa? Of big game, the lions and that sort of thing.
I will cut a couple of words off of your question. How much have you donated to conservation of animals? Period, question mark, end of statement.
Right. These are just crybabies, bedwetters, worry warts that have found something to, the charismatic megafauna. Oh, I love it. They don't care anything about the pigs, the chickens, the cows, and you know, all these other animals that that get killed every year. And
some of them do.
Some of them do.
But they don't do anything about it.
Most
other
of
than
them are crazy.
Cry and post on Facebook, don't eat meat because meat is murder.
Yeah, well, some of them certainly do that, and I don't think any of them know anything about farms either.
Right. There was a letter to the editor that I've seen this thing in print numerous times where some crazy moon bat wrote and said, hunters shouldn't go out and kill food. They should buy it from the grocery store where no animals were harmed.
I wonder, that has to be a spoof, right? I saw a Facebook meme. I'm going to get slightly off track here. I saw a Facebook meme with one of these pigs in a farrowing cage. If you don't know what a farrowing cage is, it's a cage they put over a sow so she can't get up and squash her babies. The deadliest thing in the world to a baby pig is its mother. And
yes.
Darryl, you know this. You actually,
yes.
You were taking care of the pigs at my house, and two of them were crushed
yes.
by her mother. And, you know, when you're a 450-pound big fat sow who's just given birth and you have 15 scurrying little creatures around you, it's gonna, at some point or another, you're liable to squish one, and it's just the way things go. But they had a, you know, the sow in a farrowing cage with a dead baby alongside, and saying something to the effect of, she loves her babies just like your mother loves you, or that kind of thing. And I'm not claiming that mother animals don't know love. I'm not going to claim that, but I will claim that sows can't count. And now you, Darryl, you took a, you had this one piglet, the runt that we were taking
yes.
care of, Spike, and you would take Spike out on a pretty regular basis out of that pen.
Yes.
And Spike was used to getting handled, so Spike wouldn't make any noise, right?
Occasionally he would, but I think it was more just out of being startled.
How did Dirty Red react when you took Spike out and he made noise?
If she saw me, she would react.
Yeah.
But if he just made noise, she wouldn't really do anything. Like, she might look to see what was going on, but I was out of the pen by that point.
When Spike would be returned, was she looking all over for her baby?
Nope.
That's because she can't count to
right.
15. And
I don't think she can count to 2.
I don't know what she can count to, but she loves her litter.
Yes.
And it's important to her, and she'd sacrifice for him, and she'd do all kinds of things. I mean, you know, she's a wonderful mother, a really great pig, but she can't count.
Right.
And so to say that her love is the same as, say, you know, if humans had, which they do, 6 or 7 or 8 kids, they can count them, and they're going to feel for each child that's lost.
Right. And one major difference between humans and most animals, and I say most animals because there are some animals that will only give birth to like 1, maybe 2 babies ever in life, but most animals will have large litters. And it's because, like, you know, genetics and evolution and science and whatnot know that chances are very few of those are ever going to become adults. So it's more of a herd mentality, if you want to call it that.
Yep. And when you're looking at the animal kingdom, males are generally useless. They are only there for genetic diversity. And so, I mean, they're not particularly important to the conservation of the species. Yes, it's important to have them for genetic diversity purposes, but they're just useless eaters as far as, you know, after that. The introduction of that genetic material, that's generally what males do in the animal kingdom. They go, and then they fall asleep, right? And that's the end of the story.
I saw Bill Clinton do that.
There's the
pig, not the politician.
Well, my pig, Bill Clinton, and because he was he's been purchased and raised for nothing but eating and humping, that's why we named him Bill Clinton. I think it's pretty appropriate. He isn't old enough to actually do the deed, but man, oh man, does he like to practice.
He tried.
Yeah. He certainly will. So this is the point that I'm trying to make here is that you gotta, I mean, I know you like the furry, fuzzy animals on the Facebooks. I know you like them, and you should like them. They're compelling. They're beautiful, magnificent creatures.
And they're tasty.
And you just got to get it that The reason that they're still around is because people have economic incentives to keep them around. That's the reason that most animals are here. And you gotta, I mean, like, it depends on, you know, it depends on the animal, how many should be taken. And yeah, I get why they have, you know, licensure with the taking of animals and that kind of thing. But, you know, people gotta eat, man. And sometimes people eat the things they, and some people just want to hunt for trophies.
And there's definitely not enough time to really delve into it too deeply. But when you say about there's reasons for limiting how many can be taken, it's actually fishing quotas that have caused overfishing. Because the quota only applies when you get back to shore, which means you can catch as many as you want. You've got 2 weeks when you're getting back to shore to go through and make sure that you only have as many of and the certain types of fish that you're allowed to have.
Scrod.
Everything else is dead, so you're just throwing dead fish overboard to make sure that you're under your number.
That does happen in certain circumstances. I mean, and this is why if they're going to have regulations as far as these things, they need to be better written, and they're not. And the government's going to always do a bad job of that. So I think the best system is essentially ownership. If you're talking about the sea, ownership of a certain plot.
Yes.
And people can you know, they can work that plot of land. They're doing some great jobs with farming out on the water, farming all kinds of fish. So that's it. Another perfectly good 3 hours wasted. Free Talk Live. It's been Mark.
It could
with you.
Be off hunting Darryl. Lions. And Johnson.
Check us out in the meantime. Our Facebook page is at facebook.freetalklive.com. Our regular webpage, freetalklive.com.
Are you making sense to the boomer mindset? I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com. 80 million baby boomers comprise 25% of the population and control most of the USA's wealth. As aging parents pass on, they'll control more. Boomers are 46 to 65 years old and regard themselves as midlife. They identify as neither young nor old. They're post-minivan and pre-retirement, and they don't like being called boomers. They think me. Many of the purchases boomer couples make are individual purposes. They've been experimenters all their lives. If you want their attention, tell stories and keep it simple. If something seems complicated, boomers can dismiss it as, I don't need this. And if you're looking for work, you may be applying to a boomer, so relate accordingly. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Thursday, gold is down $29 at $1,088 per ounce. Silver is 2 cents higher at $14.81 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $287. Gold is obviously dropping today, but I still think silver is a better buy. Want to know why? Give me a call at 800-874-9760 or visit our online store at rrbi.co.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Flaming Freedom is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, July 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.66 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,085 per ounce. And according to Bitcoin...